fallout from ECOT continues today as a new report just released details how much money each local school district lost. The report adds up how much funding was diverted from districts to that online charter school that's now closed. ABC6's Ben Garbrick is live at the State House right now with which school district topped that list. Ben?
Well, Mike, the top of that list includes many urban school districts, with Columbus City Schools at the very top of the list. This report says Columbus City Schools lost about $63 million in its funding to ECOT over the last 6 years. But the people who put together this report say rural districts were hit just as hard. This report was put together by the progressive think tank Innovation Ohio. Southwestern City Schools was also near the top of the list with about $16 million in funding going to ECOT. The state is still trying to get back about $80 million in fair money. It says ECOT overbilled the state. State officials say ECOT tried to get more money for students it didn't actually have. School officials from across the state shared their stories about how money originally going to their districts were diverted to ECOT. They say that money could have gone to pay for teachers, buses, textbooks, and other needed expenses.
It would erase the need for us to possibly ever have to go to those levies. Property taxpayers pay for this. We've seen this experiment fail, and we continue to pay for it.
Senate Republicans are responding to this report, saying many of these districts still have millions of dollars cash balance. They say school choice is still important for parents. They say some parents choose charter schools over traditional ones for a reason. Earlier this spring, the state auditor released a report saying ECOT intentionally fudged its numbers to get more funding. That report has now been forwarded to federal and local prosecutors to see if any criminal charges might be appropriate. Live at the State House, I'm Ben Garbrick, ABC 6 News.